Hey, I'm Jonathan Sewell, sales at Mitchell Mazda and Mitchell Lincoln on the Boulevard in Enterprise. And I wanted to just real quickly cover a topic that's been getting a lot of attention here recently with a lot of these new incentives from the manufacturers. And there's a term called deferred payments. So what does that mean? You may see it on TV or hear about it on the computer or from your preferred dealer or salesperson. 90 days to first payment, or there's some 120 days to first payment. So I thought it appropriate, and some things I've heard this week, to share that with you just so everybody's on the same page and we know what that means. So let's just say, for example, that you are financing a car, let's just say 0% for 60 months. Okay. So Lincoln has some programs now that are 0% for 60 months. Now, what they're offering is a 90 days to first payment. So your 90 days to first payment means that for the first 3 months, you don't make a payment, okay? So actually that term, the finance term, stretches to 63 months from calendar purchase day to last payment day because you're not paying any payments in that first 3 months. Now, this is 0%, so you still have the same payment and no interest throughout the whole term, and you still make 60 payments. It's just the last payment is going to be 63 months from when you purchase the car. So it's not going from 60 months to 57. So there was a little bit of confusion there. So when you have 90 days of deferment, or 90 days to first payment, it's not saying 60 months now becomes 57. So they're not skipping or waiving payments. They're just not requiring a payment for 90 days. So again, that term goes from 60 to 63. I hope this is clear. Now let's just look at a different situation here. Let's say that it was like 1.9 or 2.9. In other words, a loan with interest, 1.9 or 2.9 on 72 months, and the lender would let you do 90 days to first payment. So that term becomes 75, right? You're adding the 3 months on the end of it, so it becomes 75 months total term to pay off that vehicle. However, because it's 1.9 or 2.9, whatever the rate is, it's not important at this point. Because there is interest being charged, interest will accrue over that 90-day period. So even though you're not making a payment for 3 months, interest is still accruing. So when you have, let's say a typical loan is either, you know, buy a car today, pay your first payment next month. So that's 30 days to first payment in most cases. Or commonplace now is 45 days. So interest is still going. That difference from 30 to 45 to 90 days, interest is being accrued. So your payment goes up a little bit as you change from 30 days to 45 to 90. So when you're looking at buying a car and someone says, hey, we can give you 90 days to first payment, what that means is when you trade today, you're not gonna have a payment due for 90 days, but that 90-day payment, if there's interest, is gonna be a little bit higher, not much, depending on the interest rate, than if you did 45 days or 30 days. And again, when you talk about the term of financing, 60 months, 72 months, 75 months, 84 months, whatever you're talking about, that is the term of what your payment is figured on. If you waive payments, right? If you defer payments, you're actually adding those payments at the end. So instead of 72 months, if you do 90 days, it's actually 75 months. Or if it's 60 months and you do 90 days deferred, it's actually 63 months until that loan is complete, finalized, paid off, okay? If you have any questions or comments on this, drop them below, or you can always call or text me at 334-718-0504. I hope I made this clear and didn't get twisted up on it. I guess it's worth telling you that there are some programs available now that waive payments. In other words, when they waive payments, you are not liable for those payments. Most commonly, we see those on leases. However, right now, there may be some manufacturers out there that are waiving payments. And what that means, when they waive a payment, that means your 60-month payments do decrease. So when they say, hey, buy this car and finance it for 60 months and we're going to waive your first payment, or lease this car for 36 months and we're going to waive your first payment, that means that you are taking that term, 36-month lease now becomes 35 payments. 60-month loan now becomes 59 payments. Okay, so there's different terminologies there. Deferred payments, or 90 days, 45 days into your first payment, and payment waiving or payment waiver program is going to eliminate those payments, whereas these deferred payments just get tacked on to the end. So again, if I was clear, if you aren't confused, fantastic. If you are confused, drop a comment below, text me with your question. I'll try to answer it the best I can. And I am going to work on a video a little bit later. Stay tuned for that on why it actually is a good time to buy a car. However, deferred payments for 90 days hopefully gets us past into the late summer and past all this questionable stuff and all these new things going on and the shelter orders and all this other stuff. So it is a good time to think about some things. I know that also just about every finance institution, if you're having financial problems, call them before you're late. Reach out to them before you can't make a payment and tell them, hey, I think because my job's altered or my hours are altered that I will have some struggles, and they'll work with you on it. So we're all in this together, and I'm here for you. If you have any questions about that, anything about financing, borrowing money to do whatever, purchase a car, anything around purchasing, leasing, I'm here for you. So thanks for watching, and thank you especially all of you subscribers, because I just hit 1,000 subscribers. And so I really appreciate that. It's been several years of hard work for doing that. And I really appreciate it. So thank you very much. And I hope that this message finds you well, and that God continues to bless you during this time.